the subject was very good, you know, and I think that's a way of involving a lot of people, isn't it? And I was absorbed by it.
What do you think of him, Wyn?
Like, not my type.
Doesn't float your boat.
No, it's very nice to see how things originated in other countries.
It makes me wish I'd been back. It's a worthwhile place to visit.
Can anyone tell me what this might be? I will bring... Eileen, have we got a Scot in the room? And what's it for, Eileen?
Stirring the porridge.
It's for stirring the porridge. Excellent. A spretzel it is indeed. Alive is a charity that was founded in 2009, and our mission is to enable older people living in residential care, and especially those living with dementia, to re-engage with their memories, their most important experiences in their lives, the things that give them their identity. Through working with the team at the Russell-Cotes Museum, we've created the Museums to You project, which allows us to do just that.
This painting, Anno Domini, is by Edwin Long, who was a great favourite of Merton Russell-Cotes. And you can see in the whole gallery, we've got lots of his paintings. And he specialised in these scenes of ancient Egypt.
The Russell-Cotes, Sir Merton and Annie, travelled extensively around the world at the end of the 19th century, from New Zealand to Japan to Russia and parts of Africa. So we're going to be looking at some of their travels, share some artifacts, some pieces with you. You're very welcome to give me whatever opinion arises in the moment, whatever it may be. What is this picture depicting? What is it? It's a very famous story. It's a very famous story.
It's in Egypt.
It is in Egypt.
I was going to say.
Mary with Jesus, the flight, the
yeah,
flight to Egypt.
Yeah, that's trying to think of. Yeah, I was trying to think of that.
When it was first unveiled, people queued around the block to see it. It was like a blockbuster movie today. People couldn't, you know, they had to queue up to go and see it. It was so popular.
You take ages looking at that picture to find all the details.
Well, exactly, there is so much detail.
That's amazing.
Yeah. There's a lot going on.
You get a school children to write an essay.
Yeah, well, they could, couldn't you? Yeah.
The painting is really wonderful and, yeah. I have been to Israel, but I hadn't been to Egypt.
It's called the Fruit Cellar, for reasons that are fairly obvious. But what do we think? Because people like this. It's quite an amazing painting. Painted in 1900 by an artist called Signorini, if I remember rightly. Just the variety and the whole kind of way that it's just a completely different culture. But it is beautiful, isn't it? Someone asked me as well, said, where did you get a photograph so big? It's that clear and it's that well painted. It looks very much like a photograph. Has anyone got any other stories of travel? Because I know you travelled greatly, Robin. Because I was fascinated by your story of Patagonia and the mountains.
If you're on the way to the South Pole in South America, Patagonia is the last bit of land.
Wow.
But it's wonderful, wild mountains and lakes. Very extreme cold.
Yeah.
You need to take your gloves with you.
These sessions not only allow the participants to voice their opinions on the pieces from the collection that we show them, but it also allows them to share their memories and experiences in a social setting. From tales of romance and adventure that wouldn't be amiss in a Bond movie, to just daily stories of everyday life, these sessions shine a light on the very real lives of a generation that could so easily be left behind in a rapidly advancing technological society. By sharing these memories, be they humble or grandiose, we bring these people back into connection with their communities.
Been very good here today.
I enjoyed it all.
The pictures, you showed one or two last time, didn't you? But,
yeah.
But I thought those were fascinating.
The beauty of the painting and the reality of the paintings, yes. And especially the one with Mary and Joseph.
Come back next week, will you?
Might be able to go there again one day when I'm a bit better.
Merton and Annie Russell-Cotes gave their collection and their house to the people of Bournemouth in 1907. And so it's absolutely fitting that we should be making this collection, this wonderful collection that we have here, available to as many people as we can. And so working with Alive on the Museums to You programme is one way of doing that. And we really hope to extend that further.